Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. I hope you're doing well wherever you are. For those watching us for the first time, remember to subscribe, like, share, leave a comment. Feel glad as you join us. So today, there's a problem here. I have a typical problem here of where we are required to find the area of this shaded part. This question falls under calculus. And it is requiring that we need to compute the area under this shaded part. So there are three formulas that I'm going to use. I'm going to use the first approach. I'm going to use the integration method. The second approach, I'm going to use the trapezoidal rule. And the third approach, I'm going to use mid ordinate rule. So we have each and every step that you require in order to calculate area of this shaded part or any other shaded part that will be given. So stay in touch. Don't touch the dial. For the new subscribers, remember to hit the like button so that you turn the notification button on. Let us start with the first approach. The integration method. Integration method. First thing, I'll be required to find the limits at which this shaded region lies. Remember, we have two equations. We have y is equals to 3x, and we have y is equals to x squared. So for us to get the limits, I'll equate y is equals to 3x to y is equals to x squared, so that I'm able to get the limits where the shaded region lies. So when I do that, 3x is equals to x squared, then it is a quadratic equation. I need to bring 3x the other side so that it gives me x squared minus 3x is equals to 0. Solving it quadratically, I can factor out x. I'll get x minus 3 is equals to 0. Then it means probably that x is either 0 or another x is, when I take it on the other side, is positive 3. So when I come to my diagram here, on the y-axis, value of x is there, and 3 means that the farthest end where they are meeting, the value of x there is 3. Well, so using the integration method, I will integrate this curve y-axis from 0 to 3 with respect to x, because always integration gives us area under the curve. I'll subtract also the limit from 0 to 3 of this other curve with respect to x, then I'm sure I'll end up with the answer. Let's see. If you integrate 3x, you get 3 over 2x squared. And then if you integrate x squared, probably you're going to get x power 3 over 3. So when I do that and substitute where 3 here, I'm going to get 3, you're going to get 13 and a half. If you subtract here, if you equate and substitute 3, you're going to get 9. And that means my answer will be 4.5 square units. So that is what I'm getting using the integration method. So for the trapezoidal rule, formula A is equals to 1/2 H bracket Y naught plus YN 2 Y1 Y2 as it goes like that. But H is equals to divide by how many number of strips? So I want to divide this into 3 strips. Into the 3 strips. So H is equals to 3 number of strips 3. H is 1. So this is 1, 2, 3. So when x is 0, substitute in y is equals to 3x. And this is 0. When I substitute, plus 0 plus 2 into 3 plus 6. My answer becomes 5. And when I substitute, so when x is 0, y is 0, so area becomes 1/2. This gives me 13.5 minus 9.5 is equals to 4. So that is area using trapezoidal rule. We have H into y1, y2, y3. But our h is 1. So have x and y, and substituting y is equal to 3x, and remember in ordinate I use the mid values. So here I'll use 0.5, 1.5, 2.5. So when I substitute in 3x, I'll have 1.5, 4.5, 9.5, 7. Into 1.5 plus 4.5 plus 7.5, get the answer as 13.5. Then I'll substitute again in x squared. Substitute, I get 2.25, 2.25, 2.25, and 6.25. Look at 1, 6.25, you get 8.75 area. Answer now becomes 4.75. So that is the end.